Well, the one who is cheap and who have got a lot of life cycles, that's the ideal battery. We use lithium phosphor cells. We use 16 of these.
Yeah.
Basically, we chose this type of batteries basically because it's a very reliable, very safe batteries with puncture and so on, don't catch fire. And was for a very important issue because we want to have that as safe as possible. Mm-hmm. Second, these kinds of cells were for us very easy to package. We got 16, so two rows of 8 cells. Combination with our own developed battery management system on top of it. So that's the reason why we choose this kind of battery. Well, they are cube-wise, so you can easily package. We do both. We definitely don't take out more than the 100% out of the battery. We keep a big amount. We use less than the maximum capacity of the batteries, first of all, to be sure that the life cycle is it's good for the life cycle. And second, when the battery is getting old, the maximum power, the amount of energy getting less and less and less. So we start already with less, so then the battery is getting older, the range will not kick in because we've got a certain amount over in the beginning. So then a customer who thinks, okay, I can always drive to my work, and even when a car was 3 years old, he still can have exactly the same range and not in the beginning too much. And then when the battery is getting older, it's getting less and less and less.
Okay.
No, we don't need, because our battery is actually capable of pulling out much more amps than what we are doing.
Okay.
That has all to do with a bit our registration of the vehicle. We are only allowed to take 2 kilowatts per motor. We don't need to cool the batteries. We keep our eyes open. It's always a combination of prices, availability, because not everybody is willing to deliver your batteries. How easy can you package in the vehicle? So there are a lot of reasons why you choose a specific kind of battery. Yeah, that's a good question. Single cell, quite simple, because you charge it, you know which kind of voltage you have to cut off. With lithium cells, it's different than with lead acid batteries, is that when you charge them, they have the tendency that the voltage of one cell is getting higher and the other one is lower. With lead, old school lead, but the efficiency with charging, they all end up with the same state of charge.
Mm-hmm.
With lithium, you have to be careful, and that's why you have to use a battery management system, which measures the voltage of every cell individual. Take a look of that, and then see, hey, that one is too full, you have to empty that one a little bit. Mm-hmm. And that one is too empty, we have to the high place. Around 4.5-5 hours. Yeah, we with the Carver, we don't have a quick charge, so we have no DC charging.
Yeah.
We wanted to make it as simple as possible. It's just like vacuum cleaner, you can put it in any socket you would like.
Okay.
So if we want to increase the charging, decrease the charging time, we have to put a DC charger. At the moment it's 4,000 cycles, and that's a long time. To be honest, we haven't that's what our manufacturer, our supplier is guaranteeing us. So, but we have not reached that point at this moment, if you calculate 4,000 times and then 4,000 days of driving,
yeah.